All right, let's make it a little, bam, there it is. How's it going, everyone? Beautiful people of YouTube. This is Jose Trujillo, and I must apologize that I started without you guys, and then I was like, oh shoot, let me put my awesome camera and record this. I'm coming to you with my Starbucks, yeah. All right, here we go, look. I apologize, I started before, but I mean, you guys didn't miss much, you know. This is, simplicity is the religion that we, oh no, we don't have a religion here, but if we had one, it'd be simplicity. All right, check it out. What am I doing? Oh, gee, I don't know. Oh, dang. Too fun. Unless, you know, unless we go through a period, I think, of art where not knowing is okay, I think it will be very difficult to be creative. And I know that, you know, other people say, dude, you're crazy. That's not true. You could be very organized, eloquent, and, you know, whatever. That's not my jam. This is my jam. What I'm trying to say is that even if you paint, you know, even if you do the whole layer up and, you know, over layer, wet and dry, as it's called sometimes too. It's also okay to not know sometimes. You know, this is one of my favorite ways to look at life. I'm not always like that. Like, you guys hear me talk about this stuff. Of course, I don't always function like that. Sometimes I'm just like effing it off really bad, right? I'm like, oh man, I didn't get it. But for the most part, I try to remember. You know, I try to remember. Hey, what's going on here? Am I thinking too much? Am I overthinking this? Is this, you know, if it's causing me anxiety, or if it's, that's one way of looking at it, okay, you guys? And I'm sorry about the colors. I promise that I will keep my promise. I promise again that I will keep my promise. I sound like when I talk to my kid. I will keep my promise to show you guys the colors, right, and talk more about that, because I know you guys love that, you know, you guys are very interested in that, as you should. I think it's important, but this is what we have right now, so until I get that going, we'll get to that. But anyways, that's not you from Nacho Libre would say. This whole thing of getting it right. The heck was I saying? Yeah, getting it right. You know, trying to figure it out. You know, it's good. It's part of it. You know, it's part of the. You know, it's part of the thing. I get it. But I believe that you have to have a. Artwork is a certain level. I think it's a dance of. You know, and you don't know, and I know it's, you know, of course, this is all, I think all the greatest truths in life are paradoxical, if that's a word. I think all the greatest truths are like that, you know, they dance between the in opposition, right? They have yins and yangs. And the reason why I say you want to have an element of not knowing, it's because I believe that that is the true element of art. The other one is the methodical, right? The skill, the learned, right? The book. You know how people say there's book smart and then there's street smart, right? I think they're trying to say that, you know, that that you have that which is learned. You know, if someone's operating on you, right, a doctor, I hope they have the books marked down, right? I'm not talking about winging it. I'm talking about, although I do tend to wing it a lot, but that's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about having the skill, of course, but also having that place where you don't need to know, right? You don't have to be sure. And in artwork, I believe that's crucial. In artwork, that's crucial. One of my favorite quotes is from this philosopher. Those of you who are into philosophy, what's his name? What's this cat's name? This super awesome guy who used to say, "All I know, I don't know." I don't know the quote in English, but in Spanish, it's "Solo sé que no sé nada." I know I know nothing, or "All I know is that I don't know." I think it was Socrates. It might have been someone else. Who knows? I'm not a philosopher, you guys. So those of you who know, please put it in the comments below. But anyways, what a beautiful way to start. You know, if someone's asking him a question, and you know that this guy's like super, you know, this guy's super smart, right? Any of those philosophers, they're super, super smart, right? Well, they were, whatever. And if someone was going to ask him a question and he started his answer with "I don't know," it's not a sign of humility. It's a true sign of intelligence, in my point of view. You know, if he starts out by answering the question from a clean slate, then you want to listen to him. That's how I feel anyways, that kind of stuff. Anyways, I don't wanna bore you with that kind of stuff, but you know, I think it applies to artwork. It's the same thing, you know, it has to do with when you're going to start artwork, it is good to start with a place of not knowing. Many of us, and I know there's different types of art, you know, but many of us try to start out from, I gotta sketch it right, and then I gotta measure it, and then I gotta pull out one of those things that, I'm not saying that's bad. If that's your jam, that's awesome. What I'm trying to say is that sometimes it's okay not to do that. Just like sometimes we may be too abstract, maybe sometimes it's okay to refine a little bit too, and to pay more attention to colors, and to pay more attention to contrast, to pay more attention to values, to composition. That is also needed because you need both, right? You need both aspects. I'm not saying you just need the free aspect, because that, you know, that then where's the growth, right? If everything is you know, checks and balances, man. If everything is just pushed once one way, then where's the growth, right? But I am saying, what I'm trying to say is be a little bit uncomfortable with not knowing. The idea of not knowing is uncomfortable. You know, it's one of the reasons why we hate speaking, public speaking, right? It's like, well, what if I look like a dumbass? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, we always say that people are going to laugh, but I think that, why are they going to laugh? They're going to laugh because our self-image is going to appear unwanted or something. I don't know. I imagine. Those of you who are psychologists, please put your comments below. And also, don't forget to share this stuff. This stuff is awesome. I think. This stuff is pretty cool. You know, someone out there who's like, I'm an artist, but I also tend to paralysize. Well, fear no more, my brother or sister. You're in good hands here. I, quite frankly, don't care about that kind of stuff. You know? It's okay. It's okay. It's okay not to know something. It's all right. Give yourself room for error. Where there's room for error, there's room for growth. Many of us don't You know, one of the very things that I saw this I think it was a podcast, or not saw it, but heard it from one of those awesome guys who like to speak truths. And this guy was saying that they did he knew about this this study, right, about people and old people, you know, old folk homes, right? And they were saying that the study confirmed that one of the, or the main thing that people regret in life, right, at an age where they're ready to transcend this physical form. it sounded so cool, huh? Transcend the physical form. One of the things that they regret the most, the main thing that kept popping up, it wasn't like, man, I didn't talk to my brother, or man, you know, I should have never done that to my family, or this or that. Like, people have regrets like that, right? But the main thing is not what they did, hear me out, but what they didn't do. And that spoke to me. I don't know about you guys out there, but that spoke to me. It spoke to me deep, because this is the one thing I believe that we forget, and I think we forget not because of choice, but because we're built that way. We forget we're going to die. And I know I don't want to talk about, you know, oh man, why are you talking about death? No. Hear me out. We forget this is transient, right? Maybe somewhere in our DNA or our, you know, intuitive intelligence, we're supposed to forget or not care about that, because otherwise, you know, then we start thinking about that and then life just doesn't make sense anymore, right? Well, what for if we're going to die? But I think that since we don't think about that, right? Maybe we're built that way. I don't know. Who knows? Who knows the answer? Please put your comments below. But we don't think about that. So because we don't think about that, I think we stop living to the fullest. You know, we tend to act as if we have more than enough time. We tend to act as if talk, think, and act, right? As if time is this abstract thing that, you know, it's like air. You just, you know, it just never gets, you can't get rid of it, and it's free. And, you know, to a certain extent, of course, again, you know, the yins and yangs, right, again, show up. Of course, you there is a lot of time. And yet there isn't, right? Just like everything. And, but I think because we think like that, automatically, we just don't place much importance in that. And we think that we end up maybe sometimes tricking ourselves. And it just spoke to me a lot, you know, when these people are like, it's not what I did wrong, but what I didn't do. And it spoke to me because I think we don't do stuff that scares us. You know, things that scare us. I don't know. We act as if we're going to be, as if we're like the Volturi, these vampires, right? I got that because my wife loves Twilight. Anyways, we think we're gonna live forever, right? We're gonna be these vampires that are like, oh, I'll leave that for next century. Oh no, hell no. It's no next century for you. It's right here. You know, but we tend to think like that. Like, what? Take those piano classes? I'll come back next century. Or, you know, I'll leave it for now. I don't know. I feel like we act like that. And the reason I'm saying all this spiel, it's not just because I love giving guys my spiel, but because I think it ties to this. You know, I ponder about this kind of stuff sometimes. And if you don't mess up, I mean, the whole fear is messing up, right? Because I don't know, maybe we think we're being watched. Maybe we think we're celebrities and nobody really watches. So in our mind, we're like, what if my, I don't know, my three Facebook friends see how horrible I painted that? My self-image, oh no, what will become of me? I don't know. I just imagine this stuff. And but if you allow yourself to mess up, if you allow yourself to, you know, what growth will be there? Of course, it's uncomfortable, right? Of course, you have to go through the uncomfort. That's why we don't do it. But if we allow it, I just imagine, you know, as human beings, if we allow the uncomfortable of the self-image, which is the most uncomfortable, you know, the most uncomfortable is the self-image, the tarnishing or the, you know, of the self-image. You know, I remember when I was, well, it's not that long at all, but when I was starting out to paint, I would labor on the painting, and my skill set wasn't even anywhere near as, you know, as today, as how great I am today. It wasn't even near there. what I'm trying to say is that I didn't even have my basics down, right? Now I gear off my basics, but I didn't even have them down. And I would sit there and be like, oh man, but what if I do the tree here instead of here? And I'm like, whatever, you know? And it's not whatever as I don't care. It's whatever as I know that it's not that big of a deal if I want to put a tree here. And because it's intuitive, because I don't care. It's okay. If something goes wrong, I'll start again, you know? If something goes wrong, what could go wrong? What's the wrong thing that's going to happen? What, that I discovered that putting a tree here actually helps the painting? You know? I don't know. I just, you know, that kind of stuff. And we can be so afraid. You know, I don't think we all are afraid, but I think the vast majority of us, human beings, we tend to make this monsters, right? What is fear, you know? False events appearing real, right? That's, yeah. Duh, right? That's, but that's how we tend to live. This idea that, you know, what's going to happen if I get a little bit of red and sprinkle it? I don't know. What's going to happen? And maybe I shouldn't put red there, maybe I should, but you know, all you're really creating when you go a little bit beyond the comfort zone is you're creating learning experiences. And this is fascinating to me. It's fascinating to me because I used to think that it was a waste of time. I used to think, I gotta find out the right way of doing it, because if I don't do the right way of doing it, how much time and effort had I wasted there? This is the biggest lie of all, and I can't teach it to you. You're gonna have to go through it. You can grasp this and tell yourself, oh man, that cat's saying something deep. But until you start doing it, or you probably do it in another aspect of your life, maybe you do other stuff, well, of course, right? Not maybe. You don't just paint, you do something else. It doesn't have to be artistic in order for you to understand that. That unless you start doing it and then you do the wrong thing, right? You figure out that it was never wrong. That it was actually, you had to. It's kind of like the whole concept of kissing a lot of frogs to get to the prince, right? Or the princess. Right? It's kind of like that. It's kind of like a, you do all these quote-unquote wrong things, but you're not really doing anything wrong. There's nothing wrong you're doing. You're going through the only wrong thing that there is not doing anything at all. That's, to me, that's the wrong thing. I got some people telling me here and there, I love that word, those words here and there, it means like it's happened, okay, that's what it means. I've got some people telling me, sometimes, you know, you were doing things wrong, or you know, not just in painting, right? Which I don't really care, right? Not just in painting, but just in general, right? You're doing things wrong. You're doing this wrong. You're doing that wrong. Your YouTube videos don't have enough lighting. You know, if I waited for my YouTube videos to have the right lighting, I wouldn't. You guys would never see me. You would have never heard of me. You know, and I'm not saying be sloppy. I'm saying whatever. Get started. You know, you fix it on the way. That's one of the greatest advices I've ever gotten. I got it from one of my awesome mentors. Because you know, mentors are awesome. If you don't have them, go get yourself one or two. Don't get yourself so many. The reason why is because you'll get confused. One or two is more than enough. Preferably one. Go deep on it. Anyways, enough of that. So people say, you know, you're doing things wrong or whatever, but this is what I've learned. Look, the only wrong thing here is not doing anything at all. If I'm doing something wrong, right, this is what I want you to get. I'm not here to teach you to paint like me, because I can't. Even if you were to try to do it, you can't, because everybody's got their je ne sais quoi. I'm trying to show you a little bit of what's worked for me, and hopefully, maybe, I don't know, you apply it in your stuff, in your own style, in your own themes. I don't know, for all I know, you don't like to paint landscapes. For all I know, you like to paint surrealist stuff. Apply it to your stuff. Who knows where it'll take you. Maybe you'll never apply it to an actual work of art of yours. Maybe your stuff is different, you know? It's more precise, it's calmer, it's different. But maybe it'll serve you as an exercise. Who knows, you know? And maybe next time you paint, you know, something, the stuff that you do, it'll remind you and be like, oh, okay, I watch this cat who's like, I need to exercise so I don't get stuck, right? That's really what I'm saying. All I'm really saying is that analysis by paralysis, baby. That's all. That's your enemy right there. It's not my rants. It's your thinking. It's never my rants. It's the thinking. As Shakespeare put it, I don't know. He said something about that. Those of you who know what Shakespeare said about thinking, please put it in the comments below. So see, it gets built up, but it's by true inspiration, and I'm not trying to sit here in my laurels. I'm trying to say it's allowed to be. I've allowed many paintings, hundreds, thousands of them to be. You don't have to paint thousands or hundreds. It's just the way I do it. But you can allow, you know, your one painting to be. Like I said, I don't know if you don't paint like this. You paint different. You paint, you know. And I'm not saying different as in very different. I know we all kind of paint similar. Especially nowadays, you know, that just about everything's been done under the sun. And now we need to move into a different place. Maybe not try to be the most unique artist. Maybe we're trying to be the most real, you know. Or maybe not the most, but maybe we're trying to get to be a bit more real, to be more present, to put it in other words. Organic. Organic is a played out word, but it's so true, you know. I got a collector who put it in a really nice way. He called it honest. It reminded me of Jessica Alba and her business, the Honest Group or something. This collector nailed it. He told me one day, you know, I love seeing your work. They're so honest, the way you paint them. I never heard that before. Put it that way, you know. I was like, oh man, I love that. I'm gonna use it in my in my CV, in my curriculum vitae, you guys. No, my collector says that I'm honest. Anyways, check it out. Check it out. I'm in heaven right now. No joke. No BS. I'm in heaven. I'm not in heaven because things are right. I'm in heaven because I'm allowing things to be whatever right, whatever the hell right means. It is. That's all I care about. It is. And in this moment, this painting and I are dancing a freaking dance together. We can't tell. The painting and I have merged. I'm in the zone right now. I am dancing the dance. And the dance is dancing with me. Or dancing me, probably, for all I know. This, my good YouTube friends, is the zone. And this is where all of us deserve to be. Not paint like this. Not paint this. But get in that state where every move is perfect. It's not perfect to the ego. It's not perfect to the mind. The mind is insatiable. It will never be perfect. You're never good enough. When Picasso said there's no unfinished paintings, a part of me thought maybe he said there's no finished painting, all paintings are unfinished. A part of me thought he said they're open. As in a transcendent, you know, dental aspect of art, of life. They're open. They never finish. But another part of me thought maybe the ego, you know, was saying, I'm never satisfied. And that aspect of us is okay that it's never satisfied. It's supposed to be that way. But good enough doesn't, good doesn't exist. The perfect, the right, you know. There only is, or it's not. Oh, I sound like Yoda. But you know what? That is no BS. That is where we all need to go. The highest order in painting is done by children. As Picasso has said. Because they are not aware of something good or bad. When it comes to artwork, children are at the highest order of artists. No one. None of us. Not the best artist paints as good as a child. As perfect as true. None of us could ever do that. The only way is to go beyond, you know, our minds. All right, there we go. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys enjoy my rambling. Look at that. Look at that. I could not think about this. My mind is too limited. I'm too stupid. I could not come up with this. This is beyond me. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And oh, let me pitch you guys. If you guys love what you see, check out my my Facebook page. Check out my what is it called? Yeah, I'm on Snapchat now. Yeah, Snapchat baby. Go check out behind the scenes, how I'm mixing the paint, all kinds of weird stuff. I'm weird. All kinds of weird stuff I do, but it's cool, cool stuff. And I'm on Twitter, I'm on LinkedIn. It's Jose Trujillo Art. My website is josetrujilloart.com. There's a link below somewhere in the comment area where you're supposed to write stuff about the video, but I don't write stuff about the video. I have my website there. Check it out. Thank you guys, and have a great day. Till next time.